I can sum this video up in 6 words. French cleat, shop vac, boom arm. The humble shop vac is pretty key in most shops, but in small shops there can be problems. Hose and power cables are probably creating a trip hazard, or you can't reach everywhere that you need with your hose. And surely no one wheels their vac around the shop. What an annoying waste of time that is. The result is that you probably just clean up less often. What we really want is the vac to be fixed, have a long enough hose to reach everywhere that you need, but everything is up and off the floor. The solution, a boom arm and a hose extension. So onto YouTube to search for a good design to use. Well, that was the idea, but what I saw was a load of builds that just didn't make the grade for me. Why not? For me, there are 5 must-haves. Doesn't use any cable ties anywhere, is lightweight but not flimsy, is easy to build but doesn't rely on glue and pins where there are shear forces, doesn't sag at all, and I can move it around the shop without needing to drill new holes in my walls. The first step in my design process was to choose a hinge. I quickly ruled out butt hinges as I wanted to conceal most of the hinge hardware. I instead picked up a small adjustable hook and eye hinge, which are generally used in hanging gates. My idea was to orientate the hook strap upside down and fix the hook to an oversized French cleat wall bracket. For the boom arm parts, I knew I was going to use birch ply, but wanted to keep the weight down while also staying strong. Here I took design influence from tower crane construction, which I figured are trying to do something pretty similar. This meant a boom arm design with alternating triangle cutouts. I then add a hook section at the end where I can wind the hose around without it falling off. The boom arm also has mortise cutouts spaced along its face, which I then paired together with tenon spacers and a second arm piece to give us a rigid structure through which we can run the hose and power cable. Finally, as all hinges got some slop in them, we need to avoid sag by running a tension wire cable from the boom arm to a swivel bracket above the cleat hook. Let's take a quick look at the hardware that I'm going to use. We have the hinge strap, bolt, and eye, along with various screws, nuts, and washers to fix the hinge to our ply pieces. For the support cable, I have some 2mm 9-strand wire with matching aluminium ferrules that I will crimp onto the wire at the lengths needed. To attach the wire to the arm and the cleat bracket, I'm using a couple of swivel eyes which should keep movement pretty smooth. I'll then use a 5mm turnbuckle to adjust wire tension. I'm also anticipating wanting to fix the arm in the open position, and for that I've got a basic hook latch. First build step is to CNC cut out all of the parts for the boom arm. For this build I'm using 18mm birch ply, mostly from offcuts. If you want to find out all about this mortise and through tenon method using Shape Origin, then watch the video linked above and then come back. In short though, I use a 6mm spiral upcut bit and do 4 passes with autopass, tenons first, followed by the mortise pockets. I don't intend on using any glue here, so a tight fit is what we're after. For this reason, I do a 0.1mm offset in the first mortise and then do a dry fit check. The cut files that I've linked in the description have an encoded depth of 17.8mm, but on tool, I typically adjust to go 1mm deeper than the material thickness. This gives me a cleaner cut without tearing up the spoil board too much. With a quick sand cleanup done, we can start our assembly. Here I assembled the French cleat fitting first. As I wanted to use wood screws with a decent length to secure the hinge to the cleat bracket, I designed the bracket to double up the ply inserts to give me 36mm of material depth for the screws. With this second back piece, I simply used a wood glue and CA glue combo to quickly fix it in place. I could then mark up and pre-drill before fixing the hardware in place and sliding the fixing into position up on the cleat wall. To keep the hose and power cable that is upstream of the boom arm tidy, I also made up a couple of basic cleat brackets and paired with 3D printed hose clips that are designed specifically for these Festool hoses. If you're into 3D printing, then you can find the link to the STL files in the description. I'm also going to use more of these printed brackets to secure the hose and power cable within the boom arm, but we'll fit these in a minute. First, I need to mark up where I need to drill through the 2 larger tenon pieces in order to attach the hinge strap and eye bolt. It was then over to the drill press and cut through slightly oversized to give me a little bit of tolerance. Once cut, I can install the strap where I'm using bolts, nuts, and washers. The bolts here are longer than needed, so to keep things clean, I got out the rotary tool to cut them down. For the power supply, I have some 3-core flex cable, a 13-amp plug, and a 2-gang metal clad socket, which has got a surface mounted back box. I'm going to run power from my Festool shop vac up to the double socket on the boom arm. To give us a spot to mount the double socket, I skipped a couple of the triangle cutouts on one of the boom arm side pieces. Here I drilled through the arm piece so I could feed the power cable through and then wired up the socket. In the UK at least, wiring sockets with twin and earth cable is pretty straightforward, just making sure that you've got good metal on metal contact. For this, I'm using what are called bootlace ferrules and a crimping tool. Once wired up, we can do the jigsaw work of pushing all the parts together, while also positioning our hose brackets where we want them. Just takes a few minutes to have everything ready. Last step before hanging on the wall is to set up our wire rigging. For this, I've measured up roughly how much wire we're going to need with the turnbuckle mostly open. I then use a swagging tool to rig one end to the second swivel eye. I then swag another loop, which I attach to the turnbuckle. Just quickly before we do the install, I wanted to make a small request. When I started this channel only recently, I made the pretty crazy decision to make it my full-time job from the very beginning. To keep this woodworking journey alive though, I for sure need your support. If you're enjoying my content and have got some value, then it would be great if you can like, share, and subscribe to my channel. This will be huge in helping me keep doing more of this for you guys. When it came to hanging the boom arm, I hit a big problem. Getting the boom onto the wall was simple enough, and with the boom perpendicular to the wall, I could use a spirit level to adjust the turnbuckle to get the arm level. However, when I pushed the boom arm against the wall, there was a huge amount of sag. At this point, my heart sank as I was a bit of a loss as to how to fix it. Eventually though, it dawned on me that having the swivel on the French cleat bracket horizontal meant that the pivot point was moving instead of being fixed. So I thought to test whether having the swivel mounted vertically would make a difference. I rigged this up with a few bits of scrap and then did another test. The result was a massive improvement, but still around 1 centimeter of sag. Here I realized that the locking hooks that are on the cleat bracket had a small amount of play in them, which over the length of the arm was probably the cause of the remaining sag. This wasn't a problem though, as given I needed to make a few mods to the cleat bracket to increase clearance, I decided to make up a replacement with a better design where I could also fix the tolerance. With the new bracket made up and fittings reattached, it was back up onto the wall and it was good to see that there was no play in the locking plugs this time around, and it felt really solid. Though I did think that adding the hook latch to secure when open would be beneficial, so added this on with another cleat bracket. Last step was to fix the second hose and see if I have enough space above my HVLP dust extractor to have the hose wrapped around the boom. I knew this was going to be pretty tight given the low ceiling, but keeping the coils fairly tight as well worked out pretty nicely. Now I did also 3D print some hose clips with the initial idea to permanently attach them to my plug-it cable. However, in the end I decided to leave these off as I used the hose quite a bit for cleanup and other tools where the power cable would have just been in the way. All in, the result was pretty good, and while I personally wouldn't call this the ultimate boom arm, it fits the need that I have in my shop pretty well. Let me know in the comments what you think about this setup and if you plan to make something similar. If you're only just thinking about installing cleats in your shop, then this video would be a good place to start. Thanks, and see you on the next one.